Key 6, learn how to silence your mind.
The Lord tells us to be still and know He is God in Psalms 46:10. Still your mind, open your heart, and listen.
Key 7, be willing to resist through demonic interference.
The level of demonic interference the Lord will allow will directly depend on the sin in your life or what you are currently resisting and overcoming from your past. God promises, saying, submit to God and resist the devil shall flee. James 4:7. Be willing to stay in submission in front of God in prayer and resist the devil for as long as it takes for the demonic to lose their authority and be silenced by the Lord. Wage spiritual warfare. Command those you have authority over to be silent in faith in Jesus' name. Then resist the rest. Few things are more frustrating than being ignored. Therefore, ignore the demons trying to interfere with you and focus on being still and feeling and enjoying God's presence. As a side note, sometimes it would take me as long as 20 minutes or longer to get one revelation from God when I first started listening for His voice. Over the course of an hour or longer in the prayer room, I would come out with a few revelations. But those revelations were more valuable than precious metals. Nothing is more valuable than hearing and recognizing the voice of God. This difficulty was only for a very short season, for I pursued these revelations as much as I could, and it became exponentially easier to hear Him and have confidence that it was Him speaking to my mind. Now, I can easily communicate with the Lord all day, every day, about everything in the moment, and even pick His voice out from multiple in my mind. It was very well worth the struggle to be here.
Key 8, write down what the Lord says.
Write down what you believe the Lord wants you to ask Him, and when you have received revelation, write down the answer as well. Adam and Eve were deceived in the garden because Satan twisted God's words. Do not allow the demonic to distort or take away the revelation God is bringing you. How easily I forget, I do not know about yourself. Therefore, write down everything God says when possible. Matthew 4:4 says, Jesus answered, it is written, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes out of the mouth of God. Do not let the enemy steal or distort the words you must live on.
Key 9, do not ask the Lord repeatedly for confirmations.
Thoroughness can quickly become unfaith. Where that line is, I will let the Lord decide, for He knows your heart. When you believe you have received a revelation from God, believe it and move forward. Ask the Lord to repeat Himself too many times, and in your unfaith, God will stop speaking on that particular subject.
Key 10, have the humility to ignore your own thoughts.
You should know your own voice pretty well, and if that is who is responding, be willing to move past it and continue listening for the Lord's voice. Be patient, for learning to still the mind is a process like anything. Especially if you are very analytical, practice the faith of not having to think about anything and trusting the Lord to provide the way for your life. His thoughts are higher than ours, says Isaiah 55:9. Romans 8:6-7 says, for the mind of the flesh is death, but the mind of the Spirit, life and peace. The carnal mind is not only an enemy to God, but enmity itself. Whew, what a passage. Enmity means the state or feeling of being actively opposed or hostile to someone or something. 2 Corinthians 10:5 says, casting down imaginations and everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, that would include our carnal mind, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Again, another amazing passage. every thought, cast it down. Rely on the thoughts of Christ and Christ alone.
The link in the description will take you to a playlist with the next video. Thank you for watching.